I'll call you by your formal names, Linda Gakii Kiome, for purposes of these proceedings. So, Linda Gakii Kiome, please confirm for the record that you are an advocate of the High Court of Kenya.
Indeed so, Mwalimu.
Thank you so much. You're aware that the issue you have now brought before this Senate is a controversy as to whether you issued the advice in question or you did not issue the advice in question. Is that a correct summary of the issue?
Indeed so.
Thank you so much. The governor's case from your reading of the response to the impeachment that she received this advice. Is that not correct?
That is correct.
Your position is that it is not you who issued this advice.
That is true.
Just for my own understanding, is it your case that the governor, as a matter of fact, never received this advice?
I may not know, but I am not the one who prepared this document, and I am not the one who signed this document. In fact...
Sorry, Linda, the time here is such a big issue. I wanted to just make a clarification. Is it your case that, as a matter of fact, the governor never received this advice?
From me? No.
No, I'm not saying from you. I'm saying, as a matter of fact, you never received it.
I may not know.
You do not know. And what would bother this Senate, if I sat where the senator's seat would be, why would you come to make this kind of grave claims against the governor? That is a legitimate question, isn't it?
Indeed, so.
Let's see whether we can find an answer to that question. Linda, your services as the legal advisor to the governor were terminated by the county government of Meru, were they not?
They were terminated.
I'm happy. I just want to confirm that fact. Now, you did not take this lying law. You filed Meru Employment and Labor Relations Case number E022 of 2024 against the governor's government of Meru. So not true?
That is true.
So you have an active dispute with the governor of Meru, don't you?
Indeed so.
Thank you so much. Prior to this, Linda, you are the running mate to the Honorable Mithika Linturi in a ticket adverse to the governor's ticket in the last general election. Is that true or not true?
That is true, Honorable Members.
Thank you so much. And you are a resident of Meru County.
I am a resident of Meru County.
It is fair to say that the governor, Honorable Kawira Mwangaza, does not enjoy a very good relationship with Honorable Mithika Linturi. Is that a fair assessment?
That is not a fair assessment, Mr. Speaker, sir, and honorable members.
Okay, let me put it contrary. The governor enjoys a fantastic working relationship with the Senate, with Honorable Mithika Linturi. Is that now a fair assessment?
Mwalimu, if you had let me finish.
No, you have answered my question. I have limited time. The speaker there knows just how much time I have, and therefore I'm asking very limited questions. You said it is not fair that the governor does not enjoy a good relationship. I'm therefore suggesting to you, confirm, that the governor, Kawira Mwangaza, enjoys a fantastic working relationship with the person to whom you are the running mate, Honorable Mithika Linturi. Is that a fair assessment?
I may not know their...
You do not know. I'm happy with that answer. You are aware that there was an impeachment motion in Meru County Assembly by the same mover of the motion that brings us here today, just this month of July. True or not true?
I am aware.
And you are aware that in that impeachment motion, your termination, the termination of your services as the legal advisor to the governor was an issue raised for removal of this governor from office.
I saw the impeachment motion and I confirm that is the position.
Thank you so much, Linda. Linda, if I look at your affidavit, you want to make us believe that the person who drew your attention to the fact that this legal advice is here in Senate was Honorable D.M.K. Kiogora. Is that correct?
Honorable members, that is the true fact.
Thank you so much. Honorable D.M.K. Kiogora is the same person who moved the first impeachment motion against this governor before this Senate. True or not true?
That is true.
Thank you so much. Honorable D.M.K. Kiogora is the same person, is one of the people who signed on the motion motion in support of the removal of this governor, which motion brings us here today. True or not true?
That is true.
That is true. And therefore, it is fair for us to conclude, is it not, that you are actually procured by those who are against the governor to come and state what you have stated before this Senate. Isn't that a fair assessment?
It is a very unfair comment, Mwale.
Thank you so much. I'll leave with that. Allow me to move to something else very small, very little. We want us to believe that you came to this Senate as an independent witness, not one of those witnesses summoned by the County Assembly. No, I mean, voluntarily giving evidence for the County Assembly.
I came here to clear my name.
You came here to clear your name. But somehow, as early as yesterday, in advance of the County Assembly's application today to this Senate, you had a ready affidavit to support their evidence.
I sent that affidavit to the speaker at 10 p.m. at night.
But how was it received? The copy I've been served does not have any receiving stamp in this Senate. How was it received?
I may not know how it was received, but I sent it to the email of the speaker of this Senate.
Oh, it's your testimony this affidavit was sent in soft copy?
I did so, but I also sent DM Kiogora to ensure that it has been served.
Uh-huh. You also dispatched DM Kiogora,
yes,
a signatory,
yes,
to the impeachment motion against this government, to follow this governor, to follow up for you that this has been received here. True or not true?
Honorable Speaker.
You also sent DM Kiogora, didn't you?
I asked him to confirm.
Correct. Let's use the word asked to save time. You also asked him to confirm for you. True or not true?
It is true.
Thank you so much, Linda. Having said that, in the case you have filed at Meru Employment and Labor Relations Court, case number E022 of 2024, one of your witnesses in that case is Virginia Kawira. You know that?
No, she's not my witness. I have sued the county public service together with the governor.
Yes, I'm asking, is Virginia Kawira one of your witnesses case?
She is not one of my witnesses, honorable members.
Let me move in finalization of this matter. The opinion in question has a signature. Does that signature resemble your signature?
It resembles. I said it mimics my signature.
I'm asking a different term. Does it look like your signature?
It resembles my signature.
Thank you so much. It was issued during your term in office.
I may not know, but the dates are within
the dates. The date is with the term when you are in office.
Indeed so.
During that term, you used to render legal advice to the governor.
At that time?
During that period in office.
The governor had already asked me to make a resignation.
I'm asking, that time you were in office, had your term been, has your services been terminated?
The governor was only waiting to write for me a letter to dismiss me. Verbally, she had asked me to resign in December 2023.
Sorry, Linda, let me ask you a question that, let me go back a little. Is your advocate in your case in Meru, Ngwele and company advocates?
He is.
That case was filed on 21st May 2024.
It is.
You filed a list of witnesses in that case?
Yes, I did.
You are witness number one in that case?
In fact,
you are witness number one on that list of witnesses in that case.
Yes.
Would it surprise you that in soft copy in front of me is that list of witnesses with Virginia Kawira Miriti, yes, as your witness number two? Would it surprise you?
At the time.
Would it surprise you?
It will not surprise me.
So it is true that in that court case, the list of witnesses filed there for you lists Virginia Kawira Miriti as your witness.
At the time before the same Virginia.
Is it true that that list filed in that court lists Virginia Kawira Miriti as your witness number two?
It does.
Thank you so much.
But circumstances changed.
I have no problem with that. At least this Virginia Kawira Miriti is the same person the County Assembly has also applied to come here today and also give evidence that they were not able to procure her earlier as a witness.
Come again?
Today, the County Assembly applied for some witness summons. Are you aware that together with you, they also sought that Virginia be summoned?
I'm not aware.
I'm now putting to you as a fact that she was also summoned. Now, I want to suggest to you that these coincidences are too fantastic to be merely coincidental.
Honorable members, I was later dismissed after I filed my suit by the same Virginia Kawira, and she signed a dismissal letter against me. And now circumstances have changed. She is no longer my witness. And we have admitted to the court to ask to amend our pleadings to reflect as much. So she's not my witness.
To your knowledge, do you know of a further list of witnesses filed in that case?
I may not reflect my...
A researcher going to that court file will find only one list of witnesses listing you and Virginia.
Indeed so.
Thank you. The same Virginia who you also know has sued the county governor for the termination of the revocation of her appointment as the secretary to the service board.
I do not know.
You do not know that fact. Yes. But I'm suggesting to you that all these things I have pointed here, if you sat as an objective observer, will show that you have a bone to pick with the governor.
If I was to bring my statements for calls, I have never talked to Virginia, nor to any other member of the county.
The question was different. I'm saying all this filing of the case, you are Mithika's running mate, your name was in the impeachment motion. I would have gone into the public participation where your name was mentioned multiple times as the reason for this motion before us. We shall submit that letter to the senators because the record is before them. Show that generally you have some bone to pick with the governor. There's a quarrel you have with the governor because your services were terminated.
I have no quarrel with the governor. In fact, when I received my appointment letter, it is the former cabinet secretary for agriculture, Mithika Linturi, who told me go and help my sister in Meru County.
Thank you
and
so much.
She also affirmed that while she was giving me my appointment letter. I have no fight with the governor.
Thank you so much. I know, Linda, there is something in the Bible called the kiss of betrayal, but thank you so much. I will not rest at that.
Mr. Speaker, sir, my name is Ndego Mwangi. I'll take very few minutes in re-examination. Madam Linda.
Yes.
Did the governor
Counsel,
give you...
you only have 14 minutes.
I'll just be aware than that, Mr. Speaker. Did the governor give you the job knowing that you are the deputy governor to Honorable Mithika Linturi?
She did.
Did... The governor seems to be having a litany of cases against her former employees.
Come again, counsel?
The governor seems to be having so many cases in court with her former employees. Are you aware of that?
I am aware.
You are asked whether the issues, several issues have been raised before this Senate. The issue of whether you have filed a case and whether Virginia is your witness. And the issue in question is the memo. Is it your evidence that the signature does not belong to you?
Honorable Speaker and honorable members of the Senate, I am an advocate of the High Court. I would not come to lie to honorable members. This is not my signature. This signature has been lifted from previous documents and placed on this document.
And would you know whether the governor really received that evidence, that advice, when it's not you who gave it to her?
I may not know, Mr. Speaker, signed honorable members.
Now, what is the case that has been mentioned as relating to the question of the internal memo? Is there any relationship?
It's no relationship. This is about legal advice. And I have come to clear my name. Why? Because of the mediocrity of the advice. I would have wanted to also be a national leader. I had applied to be a PS. If I come to the committee that hears the appointments from the national government, and such a document is presented as to have emanated from me, how would I speak for myself? How would I defend myself? The only reason I am here is to clear my name And I am so disappointed that such a document would be forged with my name by Her Excellency. I have no ill feelings whatsoever against the governor.
A link has been laid that the honorable member who called you, relating the honorable member to the first impeachment motion, my question to you is there a relationship, or what came before, the first impeachment and your internal memo, the forged internal memo?
Come again, counsel?
There is a link that has been created.
Yes.
That you are here to perpetuate the deeds of the honorable member who called you, mm-hmm, to report to you about the internal memo. The question is, the first impeachment that was moved by the said honorable member, mm-hmm, was it before the forged signature?
It was before the forged signature.
So you cannot be a conduit of the said member, can you?
No, I honestly, I am not.
That's all, Ms. Honorable Speaker.